So I was gonna watch Straight Outta Compton in the movie theaters with my friend Jay Wynn, but there's a vintage motorcycle show going on, so I had to cancel. And we're gonna check this out. I think they've got motorcycles from every manufacturer, just from about every country, including the U.S., England, Germany, Italy, and even Japanese bikes, so I thought this would be interesting to see, and hopefully we see some really good stuff.
So I've been motorcycling today, and there's a lot of bikes out. And it got me wondering, why do people like motorcycles so much? I mean, why do you guys like motorcycles so much? I know why I do. I mean, it's everything they say, you know, that feeling of freedom, but for me, it really is just, it's how I feel there's a greater bond with the planet, with the earth, with everything around. Just can't get through any other machine. It's almost the feeling of flying. And you're just going through the planet, going through the world. In a way that the majority of the people never get to appreciate. And this makes you look at everything around and understand how beautiful it all is. And I think motorcycles is the only, they're the only machines that ever done that for me, so just wondering what other people's thoughts are on that. It's kind of crazy to think about if you think about it. Anyways, I love looking at vintage motorcycles, because it takes you back to a time, a simpler time, and you can see the kind of machines that they bonded with in the past versus what we see today, and there's something about the imperfection and the raw beauty of the way they built things back then, the craftsmanship that is almost gone today, that really helps you see a window how life was like back then. And it's a very romantic thing. So hopefully when we get there, there's a lot of cool bikes we'll see. And hopefully you guys enjoy this.
Bikes on bikes. That's how you know it's a motorcycle event. Looks like Indian is doing a demo here. That's the new Indian Scout. Pretty cool looking bike.
Well, we got three machines.
This is the giveaway bike. Indian is sponsoring this event. You can see all the other Indian motorcycles on the lawn and check them out. So I love going to these shows because it gives me an idea of what to do with my own bike. But look at this.
We really enjoy being here.
This is the 101 Scout. My favorite Indian of all time, my favorite American motorcycle of all time. I'm not sure how the new ones are, I've never ridden in the new one, but that right there is the mecca of American motorcycling. There's a 1915 Indian with a sidecar. Damn. Beautiful machine. Hand shift, rider mounted, rack. This one doesn't appear to have the electric headlight, which was an option at that time. Look at the kickstart.
The Cossacks and Boeing have kind of a long history.
Magneto.
Many of the Cossacks have been Boeing employees.
Beautiful, beautiful bike. All the American motorcycles are pre-1940 at this show. And I'm in the middle of the Indian section doing a roundabout here. This is probably the oldest Indian here. Leather belt drive, hand shift. Toolbox on the top. Single cylinder. Beautiful carbide headlight. Amazing. Here's an Indian four cylinder. Based off the Henderson. And this is a 1917 Indian Power Plus. And next to it is an Indian Chief. All these Indian motorcycles are legendary in America here. And I'm sure there's other bikes around, so let's take a look. Here's some vintage competition bikes. These look like desert racers. This is a Bultaco. BSA, English motorcycle. Awesome. Wow. Honda. Honda race bikes. This is a Ducati. We kind of got to stop for this one. Let's take a look at that. Ducati still, in my opinion, is on top of the competition. This is a Vincent HRD. Very rare motorcycle. Probably my favorite bike in the vintage competition class. I can't believe they even have this here. Vincent HRD. Would you believe it? Here's some American competition bikes. Harley Sportsters. Harley race bikes.
Sergeant, help him out.
The XR750 track bike, dirt track, dirt tracker.
Oopsie!
Legendary. These are cafe racers. This Ducati has probably one of the most beautiful cast engines I've seen. Wow. Yeah. Disc brakes. That is a beautiful engine. Ducati. There's a Norton 750 Commando. Look at the steering dampener. Beautiful, beautifully restored. The classic British cafe racer. This is the cafe racer featured on the show. It's based off a BMW engine. And this was actually on the cafe racer show on Velocity Channel. If you ever saw that. And other bikes here, this other Norton. This one kind of got a big tank for my taste, but it's got the old school British style headlight. Beautiful bike. Honda. What is this? Look at the engine on this thing. Look at that, all the copper. Honda GL 1100. Nice. There's a crowd around here because these are the best British motorcycles here by far. It's a collection of Vincent HRDs.
Wow. Look at that custom fuel line.
The next step you're about to do is call the cherry.
That's kick. Beautiful Vincent motorcycles. Probably has the best engine that ever came out of England. This engine is so famous in motorcycling. You can see the exhaust coming out. Everything is on the outside. This engine wears its skin on the outside. It's got tubes and everything coming out.
That's a gear shift.
So cool. Wow. Another interesting thing about the Vincents, no need for hand tools. You can basically hand screw these out, these tires. Oh. The detail and craftsmanship of these old English motorcycles, man. Unrivaled. Other British motorcycles, BSAs. Just talking to the owner of the Vincent, the series A Rapide. And man, he restored that thing himself. Amazing. Yeah, there he is. I gotta give him credit. Sitting down next to his bike. Next is Vincent. Amazing guy, he showed me all the pictures and everything. But we'll move on. Bella sets and aerials. Royal Enfield twin. AJS. And of course, Triumph motorcycles. Here's a classic Bonneville. This is a classic Triumph Tiger, I think, T100. Bonnevilles. Tram trophy. Nothing like these old British bikes, man, I'm telling you. Look at that.
She loaned you her bike and
you... Dang, they just had quality and class back then. American bikes are good too, but I think European bikes have more of a universal appeal. American bikes were really built for American roads. Here's a Harley-Davidson BA. It's got the dual headlight, single cylinder. Of course, Harley-Davidson is still around. It's one of the best manufacturers, probably the top selling manufacturer. More Harleys. Yeah, the old Harleys, man. Look at that. That is beautiful right there with the fishtail exhaust. And look at the exhaust system on this. The downward tubes. Man. That famous 45 degree V-twin.
Look at that.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Here's a single cylinder Moto Guzzi. A lot of the Italian bikes are smaller. And they've got smaller roads in Italy than they do here in America. So it makes sense, but the details, the beauty. It's just the same. Look at the valve covers on this Ducati 350. And it looks like a small bike. I'm sure it rides like a full bike. Ducati 900 Super Sport. Desmo drive. Desmo valve technology. And you can see it right here. Wow. That's beautiful. Here's an interesting Harley. It's a Harley server car. I think it's what they used to call these. They actually used it to haul things into the trunk here, like ice cream or whatever, to sell stuff. This is, looks either pre-war World War II or during World War II. More Harley-Davidsons. It's probably the most famous Harley here. Most recognizable. They all look the same though. 47. This one is for sale too. Here's a vintage German bike, a BMW. And it caught my eye because of the dual headlight setup here, the auxiliary light. That is a BMW factory part. 1969. Wow. Amazing.
There's a lot of food available here. You get a hamburger.
Here's an NSU.
And what is being made?
NSU German motorcycle.
Now, what is the secret ingredient here?
This 36 R17 BMW is so correct. The gas tank is in German. It's amazing. Probably the best German bike here. And if you look at the sidecar, I mean, look at that. That is fun right there. These are old Yamahas. This is a Yamaha 100. Maybe I should throw in my Yamaha 50cc in here one day into this competition. Take a look at some of the Japanese bikes. Get the Hondas. Just to go through quickly. Wow, Honda CBX Super Sport. This was the superbike of its time. Honda CBX. Got the six cylinders. Look at that beast. Holy smokes. Let's get a front profile. Whoa. Oh, sorry, man. No, it's okay. Honda CBX. No Honda collection is complete without these four-cylinder Hondas. So it made Honda. This is a beautiful, beautiful example. That's a beautiful Honda 504. And this is the one that made it famous, the 750. Honda 754.
You can put them in the ground.
First with electric start, disc brake.
All up to with the guy's style.
Yeah, yeah.
Can't beat this bike in the 70s. Couldn't beat this bike. This was the bike in the 1970s. That's kind of why I'm wrestling. This is a fun looking Honda right here. It's a 350 twin. Looks ready to be customized for some desert riding. This is Honda's version of the Scrambler. I love the Ducatis, but this is probably my favorite Italian motorcycle here. 1957 Moto Guzzi Falcone. Man, look at that engine. Look at that thing. And the exhaust ends in a fishtail. I'm a sucker for fishtail exhaust, man. Slippery slide. Wow. You got a heel toe shifter. Spring loaded seat. There's really a toolbox on the side. Monza gas cap. Steering damper on the top. Choke and compression release. Controls. That's probably the coolest moto Guzzi I've ever seen in my life. As Vela said, it's probably the most interesting British race bike I've seen here. The fly screen looks like an actual fly screen. It's got kind of raked bars, Smith's gauges, and look at that steering damper. Beautiful casted gas cap. The knee grips are interesting. Look, got a hand shift. Oil. Beautiful leather crafted toolboxes. Toolbox. Chain drive. Straight through exhaust. Yeah, very interesting Vela set. Yeah, it looks nice.
Okay, I'm gonna go check out that one.
Okay, yeah, no problem. We go Royal Enfield. This is the Interceptor. It's a parallel twin. This one was made in England. Royal Enfield is now made in India. But according to the owner, I was talking to the owner and she said the Indian parts will fit on this bike. So that really tells you they haven't changed much at all. Besides the number of cylinders. And this one has the modifications of only 6 of the 300 of these that were made, 300 or so. It's got the AMO carbs. Nice. Just to compare, these are the newer Royal Enfield motorcycles. They really don't change much. Hope everyone enjoyed that. Take a look at, I think that's it. We're gonna do the rewards and we're out of here.
Illinois is John Miller, and he's done a number of trophies for us out of glass. He does a lot at the Museum of Glass, our good partner in town. And John has made the best of show trophy today. John's really a fantastic artist. Whoever gets his trophy, you're getting a really nice piece. He's working on a major project for us that we might just be able to unveil here next year.
President of LeMay Museums.
I've asked John to come up. And this is Caitlin Keeley, who is our signature events manager and led the effort, does all the work for these events, done a fantastic job. Thank you for all of that. And, okay, John, you call it.
It's Andy Schwarzbucker, I think, from Squim, Washington.
Andy Schwartzbecker from Squim, Washington.
Not here, got another one.
Oh, you not here, Andy? We can be bribed. No. Unfortunately, we can't. There are strict laws in the state of Washington. They're probably here.
We try to give an award to somebody who's made an outstanding contribution to the Motorcycle Festival and to the museum. And I want to call Bert Richmond up. Bert, where'd you go? I met Bert Richmond when I read a story about on an airplane in 1998 about motorcycling across Morocco. I got back to Chicago. I called him. I said, "We're gonna have lunch." We had lunch. I said, "Where are you going next?" He said, "Tibet, to Nepal. No one's ever done it." I said, "Okay, we're going." And that started a 17-year friendship now. We've been all over the world together. Some pretty crazy spots. Had a wonderful time and created a great friendship. So Bert's contribution to this meet began a long time ago when I became CEO here a few years later and started the effort to build this museum. And I needed to build a board. And I knew we had a building project, so I called Bert, the architect, and I said, "Hey, join me." And he was the first outside, meaning non-Tacoman, to join our board of directors and led us in the planning process, architecturally designed to build what you see here today. So he was the chairman of our building committee and been with us ever since. And then after we opened, I said to Bert, "You know, we need to have a motorcycle festival." And he wasn't sure he agreed because it's a car museum. And I said, "Are you kidding me? After what we've been through?" So I convinced him to do this and lead the effort. He picked up the phone and called Terry Clark and then Mark Zahner, and the group came together. And we now have had 4 years of the Vintage Motorcycle Festival that all of us are enjoying. It couldn't have started, couldn't have happened without this guy who's tireless and gets it done, which is why I called on it in the beginning. So he got it done. He's given us an event which has continued to grow and become spectacular. And proud of you and grateful for your friendship. And I want to give you the President's Award, Bert.
Joel, and the best in show this year goes to
having trouble locating that, so we're just going to shut the show down. No best of award, best of show award. Thank you for coming out today.
Best of show, 1968, Eagley Vincent, Richard Stevens.
Coming out to the Vintage Motorcycle Festival. You can hang out for a while longer, enjoy the field, enjoy the bikes, maybe grab a bite to eat or a beer if you're still here. I'm Lance Lambert. Thank you very much for coming out to the show today.
Here are the last look at the show bikes. That's the show.
Yeah, I want you and Diana
to picture. Oh, Bart, can you answer
your
this question if you don't mind
that?
I don't want any awards.
Is any consolation that
Yeah, it is.
My colleague, it's been maintained, it's not restored.
Oh,
it was my father.
Oh,
yeah.
That's it. Heading out. Hopefully you enjoyed all that.